NBC Nightly News. With John Chancellor in New York, Chief Washington correspondent Roger Mudd, and tonight's special segment, part two of our report, Moscow's Secret Stealers.
Good evening. Millions of people mourned the tragic death of John Lennon today. The young and the middle-aged shared a sense of grief over the inexplicable slaying of Lennon, murdered by a young man who had been a fan of Lennon and the Beatles for the last 15 years. The killing took place last night as Lennon and his wife, Yoko Ono, were entering their Manhattan apartment house called the Dakota. Crowds gathered soon after, and many just stayed outside. Stephen Frazier reports.
They kept a vigil all day, making a shrine of the Dakota, where John Lennon and his wife Yoko Ono owned five apartments. Some mourners brought bouquets. Former Beatle Ringo Starr flew from Europe to console Lennon's wife and their five-year-old son. The crowd stood just a few feet from the archway near where Lennon was shot. Witnesses said a gunman followed the Lennons as they got out of a limousine and walked past the Dakota's huge iron gate.
This individual, Mr. Chapman, came up behind him and called to him, Mr. Lennon, as he arrived at that doorway. And then in a combat stance, he emptied the Charter Arms 38 caliber gun that he had with him and shot John Lennon.
Lennon died before police could get him to a hospital 1 mile away. His attacker made no attempt to flee. He was arrested at the Dakota and was moved under heavy guard because of fears for his safety. Police say he is Mark David Chapman, 25, who came to New York a week ago. He stayed at a YMCA and had been asking questions about Lennon. Just 6 hours before the shooting, Chapman is said to have asked Lennon to autograph the album cover of Double Fantasy, a recording Lennon had completed after 5 years in seclusion. Chapman entered no plea when he was charged with Lennon's murder late today. He was sent to a hospital for psychiatric examination and will be watched around the clock in case he tries to commit suicide. An assistant district attorney told the court Chapman borrowed a large amount of money and came to New York with the sole intention of killing John Lennon. Stephen Frazier, NBC News, New York.
Lennon's wife, Yoko Ono, was a central figure in his life. Just a few hours before he died, he told an interviewer that he hoped to die before she did because he couldn't carry on without her. She said today there will be no funeral, only a silent prayer vigil later this week. The prosecutor who accused Mark David Chapman of murdering Lennon could give no motive today. Chapman's attorney said the young man had tried twice to kill himself. As a teenager in Decatur, Georgia, he moved from a long hair hippie lifestyle to one of a religious fundamentalist. He later moved to Hawaii. Here are two reports on what we know of his life.
Chapman attended high school here in suburban Atlanta's DeKalb County. He graduated in 1973. Classmates remember him as a long-haired hippie type as a freshman and sophomore who suddenly changed before graduation.
Around 11th grade, I believe, 12th grade, right in there. He comes in, he's got a crew cut, doesn't wear blue jeans anymore, tennis shoes or anything. Carries a little Bible around with him. Just a phenomenal change.
He was a loner, a quiet type person. I could see him going to the extreme maybe of the Jesus movement or maybe to the extreme of, you know, the other way. I could see maybe a little bit of instability there, so I could conceive how it could happen, you know.
Chapman lived in this house while attending school. His father, who has moved to another house now, still lives in the Atlanta area. He would not comment today about his son. Kenley Jones, NBC News, Atlanta.
Mark Chapman came to Hawaii in 1977, lived here with his wife Gloria on the 21st floor. She's refused to see newsmen. The building manager had talked with Chapman several times.
Very nice, sociable fella, and very nice, pleasant to talk to, and knew what he was talking about, and did not sound like he was off his rock or anything like that.
He never gave you any trouble?
Never.
Chapman's last job was as a security guard, and in October he came here to this gun store to buy a .38 snub-nosed revolver like this, a type used often by detectives. The owner, Steve Grahovac, has had threatening calls and admits he's upset.
Sure, it bothers me. Not what they're saying don't bother me, but the incident itself. I mean, anytime anybody gets blown away, I don't feel good.
Chapman was granted a permit for the gun by police. It's easy to get a gun permit in Hawaii, and it was all considered routine. David Burrington, NBC News, Honolulu.
Former Beatle Paul McCartney said, "I can't take it in at the moment. He is going to be missed by the whole world." George Harrison issued a statement through a spokesman saying he was deeply shocked. The Beatles broke up in 1971, the most successful group in the history of rock music and maybe in any kind of music. Lennon's own fortune has been estimated at $235 million. A story of fantastic success for some young men who started as unknowns in Liverpool. John Cochran reports from the country which produced the Beatles.
In England, the death of a native son was the story.
John Lennon shot dead by the head.
British radio and television were full of it.
John Lennon is dead, shot several times by a young American.
There were interviews with people who knew John Lennon, including his high school headmaster, who recalled that he was a problem student.
Despite this being intractable, did you like him?
I was certainly very interested in him. To me, of course, he was an acute problem to all my colleagues.
The Cavern was the raunchy Liverpool club where the Beatles really got started. The old club was torn down and replaced by one that is just as seedy. Outside, there is a plaque to the Beatles, to the four who shook the world. Inside, club owner Joe Beckett said he'll put on a special concert this week to honor John Lennon.
Do the young people who come here now, do they still remember the Beatles, or are the Beatles ancient history to them?
I know the Beatles music still goes down well, actually. We've still got quite a selection of Beatles music on the jukebox, which gets played quite well. It gets played every night.
British television showed pictures of Lennon and his wife riding through the English countryside. But he had chosen to live in New York. And in a radio interview recorded last weekend, Lennon explained that he preferred New York because he felt he could live there safely and without being bothered.
Do you want to know how great that is? I mean, people come up and ask for autograph or say hi, but they won't bug you, you know?
John Cochran, NBC News, London.
President Carter said he was saddened by Lennon's death, which was made more poignant, said the president, because Lennon died by violence when he had long campaigned for peace. In a minute, we'll hear what President-elect Reagan had to say about the Lennon tragedy, and later in the program, we'll have more on John Lennon and his music. Today, he said John Lennon's murder was a great tragedy, that an answer to crime in the streets must be found, but said he did not believe that Lennon's death amounted to an argument in favor of the control of handguns. Reagan was with New York's Terence Cardinal Cook when he spoke.
Well, as I said, what can anyone say? It's a great tragedy, and it's just another evidence of that we have to try and stop happening in this world.
Did you stop that with handgun legislation, Governor?
I've never believed that. I believe in the kind of handgun legislation we have in California. If someone commits a crime and carries a gun when he's doing it, they add 5 to 15 years to the prison sentence.
Mr. Reagan is now... John Lennon was the most intellectual of the Beatles, a man who thought and felt deeply about the meaning of life, of love, and of family. He was an extraordinarily talented musician, and his music was part of that sense of loving. We thought we would end this evening with an evocation of his life and his music, and that has been assembled by Linda Ellerbee.
Came out with the name Beatles, and what does it really mean?
John thought of the name Beatles, and he'll tell you about it now. it means Beatles, doesn't it? You know, that's just a name. You know, like shoe.
Means shoe. The shoes. You see, we could have been called the shoes for all you know.
How did you find America?
I left to Greenland.
It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog.
You say yes, I say no. You say stop, but I say go, go, go.
Would you say that the same?
intellectual revolution has taken place more here or in England?
We haven't noticed.
Murderers to hang them, or help violent people to be violent to them. That's it is all they understand, but it doesn't. I don't believe violence begets violence. You know. Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. And we are humorists. What are they? Laurel and Hardy. That's John and Yoko. And we stand a better chance under that guise, because all the serious people like Martin Luther King and Kennedy and Gandhi got shot. Imagine all the people sharing all the world. You may say I'm a dreamer.
Well, that's our report for this evening. Tonight at 11:30, 10:30 Central Time, NBC News will have a special program on John Lennon, the man, and his music. Until then, good night for NBC News.